Okay, so the next project will be to clean out the coolant. I have already removed the thermostat housing and disconnected the bottom hose down here, right there. And before I did that, I've actually had the engine running for about 20 minutes with some kind of cleaning agent in the coolant system. And the stuff which came out were pretty muddy and rusty. Also have to try to clean out as good as I can down in the coolant jackets, but I don't think I can do much about that. But next step would be to remove this, which is the water pump, and renew that. I have a new one. After that, I will have to remove this hose. Actually, I will do that before because it's stuck to the water pump. But this one is broken, it got a tear down here, so it leaks. And I got a new one, which was not an easy hose to get a hold of, because it's a weird shape, and only for the Metro. And nobody wants the Metro, so nobody have the parts. But actually we got a hold of a NOS part. So that's perfect. Next up will be to remove the generator or alternator. I'm not really sure which word is the right one, because this bolt is attached to the water pump housing and I need to remove the water pump. Okay, that last bolt was fighting me a bit, but it's out now. And I'm going to try to pry the generator a bit away from the engine so I can get the water pump off. I don't have to remove the generator completely because it needs to go back on before it will be started up again. One important thing to notice is to remember that there's power coming to this generator. At the moment there's no battery in the car, so it's not a problem, but when you remove a generator, especially if you just move it to the side, take care not to short something out. Yep. That's exactly what we need. Now I will remove the hose and then the bolts. Something is doing something. These Jubilee clips can be quite stuck and will often break on old cars. Not this though. Then we can prise it off. I don't have to take care to protect this rubber because we're changing that bit completely. Also the pump. So I can prise it off. Like so. And then I have to remove the bolts. Hopefully none of them will snap. This one didn't. One thing to notice, often the bolts are different sizes. So when you put it back together, take care to put the right bolts in the right places. Because if you put a too long bolt in a too small hole, well, something is going to give. And often it gets a bit expensive that way. And now water is coming out everywhere. And then just back in a bit and get a bucket. And I'm back with a bucket. Well, actually, this water pump is a bit not straight, I think is the word. It's not that bad, but it's not straight. Other than that, it is pretty gunked up, but it seems to be functioning. But it's going to be changed anyway. Inside of here, it's not looking too good. But it's to be expected on these kind of engines. I'm going to try to put some fresh water into it and to flush some of all this gunk out, because it can clog up the thermostat and the heater matrix and the radiator. So I need to get some of that out. Okay, I have flushed the engine with a couple of buckets of water, and it's better. It's not perfect, but it's okay. This car is a good example on how important it is to put real coolant in your engine and not just water. Because one thing is that water will freeze and crack the engine or head or something, the radiator. But another thing is, if you don't have the coolant stuff in it, it will rust in the coolant jackets, and it's going to be a big problem in the end, and it's quite difficult to do much about it. This will work fine. Now I will have to remove the airbox filter, because I need to remove this funky hose down here. So I will crack on doing that. Then I will follow the hose up, and this, it goes like that. that and over there and into this. This is into the heater core in the car, which gives warm air in the car. I have a feeling that the heater matrix itself might be blocked because of all the rust scales. But we'll see. Otherwise, I will have to change that as well. But I will undo this clip and undo this clip. And maybe this is a good time to say that I'm not a professional. I'm just a do-it-yourself type. And these videos are supposed to be an inspiration to do stuff yourself and or just for fun to look at. But it's not a guide in any way. I will make mistakes, and if you follow my steps, you will make the same mistakes. Okay, I have loosened the clips, so I should be able to wiggle this one out. Oh, there's not a lot of room. Just need to break the seal, then it will most likely just slide off, like so. And it's off. Care not to crack the inlet, like so. I need something to cut this one open with. Yeah. You couldn't see it, but I got it. One hose. I will also remove this one. I think it just slides down, or maybe not. No, that's a screw right there holding it on, and right there holding it on. I think I will remove it because I think it's quite dirty down there, and yeah, it is. So that would be a nice thing to get cleaned out. Back again. This got more complicated than it needed to. As you can see now, I can get it out with the drill. In and out. Yeah. Great, this is gone now. Try to remove the other one, which is just down here. Which is not stuck, which is very, very nice. Do not drain. I must have done something wrong then. Okay. like so. Then okay, next step is to switch the old pipe with the leak out and put the new one. And it's always a good idea to check if they are the same, and it is, over on the new pipe. So, like so. Then the new one is on the old pipe. And then I'm just gonna have to take all the clips and put it over on the other one. You should use new clips, but they are okay and I don't have any. So I will be reusing them and saving the planet. And there, it's ready to go. The old one had a leak around here, a very small pinhole leak. You can see the white stuff there. It's somewhere around here, but you can't even really see the hole. And luckily, my friend found this part, which is a new old stock part. And it's quite difficult to get a hold of because it's a Metro specific part, and because the Metro is not that popular, not a lot of parts are around anymore because nobody wants to save them. Most of the other stuff on the Metro is the same as a Mini, and that's easy to get a hold of parts for. And actually, the friend who found this part is actually the owner of the car, and we are building it together. Because we have a weird dream about showing the car to the world again. Don't know why. But yeah, I'm going to put this one on now. And I'm not going to film it because it's too difficult to film. Okay, now it's time to put on the new water pump. And I find it to be a good thing to take the new part and compare it to the old part, because sometimes there's just some differences between model year and stuff, and that can sometimes become quite a big of a problem, but not here, it seems to be fine. A new gasket. And before putting it on, it is important to clean off the mating surface, because if you do not do that, then you will not be able to make it seal, that's for sure. Then you take the water pump and remember to use the long bolts where they are supposed to go, so you're not destroying anything. Apparently this one needs to be pushed out of the way. Yep, I dropped the bolt down in the engine bay. Now we need to find the bolt that I dropped. Can you see it down there? It's a weird one, but it's so nice to have when you're throwing around with everything. Then you put it down. It's difficult while filming, and then you push it, then it's got these arms which comes out. And you couldn't see it, but here I got it, and then slowly and steady. This is a nice thing. And back again with the last bolt. Put it in. And it should fit. If not, something is weird is going on. But it's not. It's fitting fine. Always make sure that the gasket is not falling the way it needs to be. Sealing all the way around. And it is. Using the fingers to begin with is always a good idea because it's difficult to cross thread it with the finger force only. Okay, and then tighten it up. You should always tighten it up in a crisscross pattern, because especially this water pump, which is aluminum, will crack very easily if it's not completely straight when you're tightening it up. Just tighten it even and not too much, because as I said before, it's aluminum, and aluminum will crack quite easily. So one new water pump. And then we need to refit this hose. Actually, I was almost forgetting about it and was starting to mix up some coolant, but that would be a shame. I once poured 4 liters, liters of motor oil in an engine where I had forgotten to put the sump plug back in, so that was difficult getting off the floor. Almost not see anything, but I got it on and now I have to fit the jubilee clip. That needs to be. I just have to tighten it up. Can you see anything? Not at all. Of course, only my fingers. Before doing much more, I will just fill up the system with the coolant from the inlet in the head of the engine, because then I can see if it leaks down at the water pump. There's coolant in here, but there are no leaks down at the pump or at any of the unions. Okay, in the thermostat kit there were no gaskets, therefore I'm going to make my own gasket for it. We need 2 pieces, identical gasket pieces, and you need to use some gasket paper, and then you when doing it like this, you need to take care not to destroy the mating surface for the gasket. If I make put dents in this one, then the gasket won't seal. So only do it when you are sure that you don't destroy anything in the process.
you couldn't see it anyway. This will do.
And again, clean up the gasket surface. That could be better, but I'm a bit lazy. And then put this one on here. Put this one in here. This is the wrong way around. Like so. And so. The last gasket.
I am finding this to be a bit difficult to film, but I will be trying to do it anyway. As you might have guessed, I was having a bit of problem with the gasket I made, because I made it too sloppy, and it's still too sloppy. So now I'm trying to fit the parts together beforehand, and it seems to be going a bit better. Actually, so now we are fitting it with one hand. Which is difficult, but doable. And once again tighten it up in a crisscross. Add on to just make sure that the load is evenly put onto the housing so it's not crack, so that it won't crack. And then the hose back on. Oh. So, and tighten it up for a bit, and then I'm going to refit the coolant reservoir. I'm not going to film that because it's a bit fiddly. Or maybe I am. So, this one goes down here. The screw needs to be taken out again. This little inlet goes into here, which is not possible by with one hand, so I'm going to try to put two right there. Like so.
some light. This is the hole. Needs to match over there.